وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ. If that's all of this wasn't bad enough, the messenger himself, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, speaks to Allah directly, Ya Rabb, inna qawmi ittakhadhu hadha al-Qur'ana mahjura. This nation of mine, no doubt about it, they took this Qur'an, hadha al-Qur'an, even there's a beauty in even the use of the word hadha here, as opposed to dhalika. Like when you start reciting Qur'an in the beginning, alif lam mim, dhalika al-kitabu la rayba fih. Here Allah does not say dhalika al-Qur'an, He says, هذا القرآن هذا للقريب. This Quran was right here. It was right in front of you, and you still wouldn't take it seriously. And the Messenger on Judgment Day, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, complains: This nation of mine took this Quran, not that Quran, this Quran. One of the other rhetorical benefits, balaghi benefits, of the word hadha in this ayah is on Judgment Day, it will be like the Quran will be brought as a witness. You know how in court you bring the witness, and then the witnesses or the evidence is brought, and you point at the evidence and say, this is the evidence that that guy is a criminal. So the evidence itself will be the Qur'an on Judgment Day. Your case is bad enough as it is. And then the Qur'an is brought as the witness, and the attorney bringing the evidence is the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he's pointing at the Qur'an and saying, these people, this nation of mine, they took this Qur'an, mahjura, they took it mahjuran. Hajara, they say in Arabic, taraka shay'an. It's hajartahu hajran, yani taraktahu, aghfaltahu. You made something forgotten. You completely ignored something. You left it way behind. I think even the Urdu speakers here know the word hijra. Everybody knows the word hijra, to migrate something. The ayah doesn't even say matrukan. Matrukan means left behind. Mahjuran means left way behind. They didn't just leave the Quran, they left it way behind. They weren't even close. They just migrated away, away, away from it. And I want to remind myself and all of you today, the character that the Quran wants from us, if we are away from that, even though we're reciting the Quran, it's still a hijrah from the Quran. It's still a hijrah from the Quran. We're migrating away from the Quran if we're reciting it and we're not seeing any change in our character. That's the quality of Bani Israel. And that's why this by the way, is Surah Al-Furqan, the 25th surah of the Quran. It's not a long surah, so you can read it in translation when you go home. What's remarkable about this surah? This is the middle of it. When you get to the end of it, the whole ending is about what kind of character is required from a Muslim. What should the personality of a Muslim look like? Why is that mentioned? When the messenger complained, they abandoned the Quran. Because the person who does not abandon the Quran has a different kind of personality. Their personality is different, their character is different, their actions are different, even who they hang out with is different. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا in the same surah. When they walk by useless conversation, they walk by in a dignified way, they don't get entangled in it. They stay away from useless company even. It affects every part of their personality. That's the abandonment of the Qur'an. I feel that the ummah is becoming, and you and I, are becoming more and more and more guilty of, and we have to be worried about it. I was reading this ayah, my daughter recites Quran to me at home. And she was reading this ayah, and I was just checking her tajweed, and she was reciting the ayah, and I sat there and I started crying. And she said, Abba, why are you crying? I said, because of what Allah said. You know, because of what Allah said. She said, what did He say? And I said, you know, He says, the messenger will complain about a group of people who left the Quran. And she says to me, but we didn't leave the Quran, we're reading it. And I said, beta, if only it was just about reading, it would have been easy. It's not just about reading it. You have to love this. Can we prove to ourselves we love this book more than any other movie that comes out? More than any video game? Do we want to spend more time with this book than anything else? Do we want to be like what this book wants us to be? More than we want to be like anyone else or anything else? How you younger guys want to look like ripped because they see a picture of a guy with muscles? Girls want to look like someone? People want to make money like someone. People idolize these people. Who idolizes the character that the Quran embodied, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kana khuluquhu al-Quran? Who like goes to sleep and I think, man, I wish I had a six pack, instead of thinking, man, I wish I had more sunnah in my life. Who says that? How are we not abandoning it? How are we not abandoning it? We have to be a people that take coming back to Allah's book seriously. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us a people that love this book and make it a big part of our lives. So everything in our life is given blessing and given life through the barakah of this book. May Allah Azza wa Jal help the Muslims understand this book as they should understand it. May Allah help you as parents not only love and understand this book yourselves, but give you the ability to teach it to your children, so your children can testify for you on Judgment Day. May Allah Azza wa Jalla help the masajid, the schools, the madaris of Hifz, all these kids that are memorizing Quran. May Allah not just help them memorize Quran, but to help them understand every word of it, and to live that word of it, and to pray with their hearts, not with their tongues when they pray. May Allah make us of those people that really live the Quran, and the Quran lives inside their hearts. بَلْ هُوَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ. These are ayat that live in the chests of those who've been given knowledge. Chests, the Quran lives in the person's heart. May Allah enter this Quran into all of our hearts. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْحَكِيمِ وَنَفَعْنِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِالْآيَاتِ وَذِكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ.